The 49ers pick is in. Trey Sermon, running back at Ohio State.
Yes.
I know we're going to go in a second to Jeff Darlington, but first I want to get a running back. I always go to Trevor Scales. For anybody that doesn't know, Trevor Scales, an amazing running back for Harvard. Trevor, give me your running back background.
No, so I just love the idea of Trey Sermon in this explosive big play offense and what he did at Ohio State with regards to, like, just accounting for the amount of offense that he did down the stretch of Ohio State's season. You can imagine him making the type of plays within that Kyle Shanahan offense in that run scheme that is so daggone creative that just opened things up for him and allows you to show the breakaway speed that he put on display in full for the Buckeyes. Like, just unbelievably productive. Comes in from Oklahoma. Ain't nobody really thinking about him being a contributing member to that offense to the extent, at least, that he was. He was setting numbers up that were akin to the only man that won two Heismans, right? Like, it was an unbelievable amount of production from the running back position in Trey Sermon, and you hope that Kyle Shanahan gets him under his offensive scheme and you get that same level of output from him.
Sermon just went off. Yeah, in the Big Ten title game. Remember, he had 324 rushing yards, breaking the record for a single game held previously by Eddie George, now the Tennessee State head coach. Congratulations to the great Eddie George on that title. It's a crowded running back room now for San Francisco, but you know what Kyle Shanahan doesn't care about? Your fantasy team. Now they've got Raheem Mostert. They've got Trey Sermon. Jeff Wilson Jr., they re-signed. They just picked up the Wayne train, Wayne Gallman. Yep. Michael Hasty played well for them last year, an undrafted free agent out of Baylor that they claimed off of waivers a year ago. Matthew, we drafted any of these guys in fantasy?
No. Listen, Trey Sermon has the chance to be a league winner this year in fantasy football. And I'll make the case here. You just said, like, people are going to ignore him because they have, you know, yeah, and Michael Hasty too, flashed. Like, they... Kyle Shanahan loves to play multiple running backs, and it's always frustrating to have a 49ers running back on your fantasy team because of that. But remember, the 49ers last year, despite a hodgepodge of guys in there, you know, Mostert, and they have Tevin Coleman at times, and they were still third in fantasy points among running backs at the running back position, third most fantasy points of a team, the 49ers. And so if they commit to Trey Sermon, and we'll see if they do, right? I know they like Mostert a lot. Trey Sermon is the kind of guy that if he could get run in that offense, behind that offensive line, really, really interesting. Like, you know, he's got a chance to be a special fantasy player if he can get run, because he's not going to cost a lot on draft day because they have so many running backs in San Francisco. But Kyle does seem to, like, pick a guy and go with it. And it's worth noting, like, they traded with the Rams to get this guy.
Right.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I mean, if you had every 49ers running back on your roster, and you could call Kyle Shanahan on Sunday morning and ask him what the carry breakdown was going to be, you could win every single week, because if you're a Kyle Shanahan running back and you have the ball, you can put up monster numbers. Right? So that, I mean, that's the problem is you never know which one of them's going to get the ball.
The other issue, though, like, or not issue, but plus, when it comes to Trey Sermon, I mentioned the big playability. He doesn't necessarily need a boatload of touches to get going. This is a guy that can just, look, get him one play a game, and it might go 90 for 6 points on the board, and that might take care of you as far as a fantasy weekend goes.
Yeah.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.